Welcome back to another video on absolute extrema. This video will provide examples using transcendental function. I would recommend that you watch the previous video first. It will go over the explanation of absolute extrema in a little more detail than this video. The procedure for finding the absolute extrema on a closed interval are as follows. Number one, we find the critical numbers of the function in the open interval. Then we evaluate the function at each critical number. Then we evaluate the function at the endpoints. And that's important that we do not forget about the endpoints. And then the least of these y values is the minimum or absolute minimum. And the greatest is the maximum or absolute max. Let's go ahead and give it a try. So the first step is to find the critical numbers on the interval from 0 to pi. So let's go ahead and find the derivative. Before we do that, we should recognize this as sine x squared plus cosine x. So when we go to find the first derivative, this is a composite function where this would be u squared. So the derivative of u squared would be 2u times u prime, or 2 sine x times the derivative of sine x, which would be cosine x. And the derivative of cosine x is negative sine x, so we'll write minus sine x. So to find the critical numbers, we have to set this equal to 0 and solve. We have a common factor of sine x, so let's factor that out. So this equation will equal 0 when sine x is equal to 0, or 2 cosine x minus 1 equals 0. Well, on the interval from 0 to pi, sine x equals 0 when x equals 0 and x equals pi. Solving this for cosine x, we want to know when cosine x is equal to add 1 divided by 2, 1 half. Well, a 60 degree angle has a cosine function value of 1 half, so x equals pi over 3. Remember, we're only considering the values of x on the interval from 0 to pi. Okay, so now we need to evaluate the function at these critical numbers and the endpoints. However, on this problem, notice that the critical numbers of 0 and pi are the endpoints on the interval. Therefore, we have to evaluate the function at these three values. Let's go ahead and do that on the next screen. We need to find f of 0, f of pi over 3, and f of pi. Sine of 0 is 0, cosine of 0 is 1. Next, the sine of pi over 3 would be square root 3 over 2. If we square that, we'd have 3/4. The cosine of pi over 3 would be 1/2, so this would be 5/4. Next, the sine of pi is 0. And the cosine of pi is negative 1. So the largest value is 5/4, that's our maximum, and that occurs at pi over 3. And the absolute minimum is the least value, which is negative 1 at x equals pi. Let's go ahead and verify this with a graph. Here's our maximum of 5/4 at pi over 3, and here's our minimum of negative 1 at pi. So everything looks good. Let's go ahead and try another. Now we're going to determine the absolute extrema of this function on this interval. So we'll first find the derivative, set it equal to 0 and solve. The derivative of sine x is cosine x minus the derivative of cosine 2x is going to require the chain rule, where 2x is equal to u. So the derivative of cosine u is negative sine u, or negative sine 2x, times u prime, which would be 2. So let's go ahead and clean this up. This will be plus 2 sine 2x. Now we have a little bit of a challenge here. This is a double angle, and we have both sine and cosine. However, there is an identity that we can use here. The double angle for sine 2x is equal to 2 sine x cosine x. So we'll use this double angle identity and rewrite this. So we'd have 2 cosine x plus 2 times 2 sine x cosine x. So we can see this would be 4 sine x cosine x. So let's go ahead and factor this at the same time. We'll factor out 2 cosine x, and we're left with 1 plus 2 sine x. So we want to know when cosine x equals 0, or when 1 plus 2 sine x equals 0. Solving this for sine x, we have when is sine x equal to subtract 1 divided by 2, when is sine x equal to negative 1/2. Okay, so let's go ahead and start off with when is cosine x equal to 0. on this given interval, we would have x equals pi over 2, and also at 3 pi over 2. Next, when is cosine x equal to negative 1/2? Well, that would be a 30 degree reference angle in the third and fourth quadrant because the sine function value is negative. So these are both 30 degree reference angles. So this would be 180 plus 30, or 210 degrees, which is 7 pi over 6 radians. This would be 11 pi over 6 radians, but that's outside this closed interval. So now we have to determine the function values at these three x values and then the endpoints. But notice that 3 pi over 2 is already a Crickle number. So we have four function values to determine: f of 0, f of pi over 2, f of 7 pi over 6, and f of 3 pi over 2. Let's go to the next screen and do that. For this one, let's go ahead and use the graphing calculator. So I'm going to go ahead and type the original function into y1. And we'll go to our table. Make sure your table is on ask mode. And we'll just type in these x values. We have 0, pi over 2. You also want to check to make sure that you're in radian mode. I've already checked that. 7 pi over 6. And 3 pi over 2. Okay, so we have negative 1, 3, negative 1.5, and negative 1. Let's go and record those. So 3 would be our absolute maximum at pi over 2, and negative 1.5 would be our absolute minimum at x equals 7 pi over 6. Let's go ahead and check these graphically as well. Here's our maximum of 3 at pi over 2. And here's our absolute minimum of negative 1.5 at 7 pi over 6. Okay, let's see if we have time for one more. To find the derivative, we'll have to use the product rule here, where this is our first function. No, this is our second function. So we have x times the derivative of natural log x plus 3. That would be 1 over u times u prime, but u prime is equal to 1, plus the second times the derivative of x, which is 1. Okay, we need to set this equal to 0 and solve. So we have x over x plus 3 plus natural log x plus 3 equals 0. Now this is kind of a tricky equation. Natural log of x plus 3 on this interval will always be positive and never equal 0. And x divided by x plus 3 will always be greater than or equal to 0. So this actually will never equal 0. So what that means is we have to test the function values only at the endpoints. We need to find f of 0 and f of 3. F of 0 would be 0 times natural log of 0 plus 3. That's going to be 0. And then for f of 3, we're going to have 3 times the natural log of 3 plus 3, or natural log 6. This is going to come out to some decimal, roughly 5.38. We have a maximum of 5.38 at x equals 3, and we have a minimum of 0 at x equals 0. Again, it's a little bit tricky here because we can't really solve this equation on this given interval, so that's why it's always a good idea to take a look at these graphically. Let's go ahead and do that. And notice that the endpoints produce the absolute minimum as well as the absolute maximum, and there are no critical numbers on the closed interval from 0 to 3. Okay, I hope you found these additional examples helpful. Thank you for watching.